and welcome to Azure AD Architecture Deep Dive Series. I'm Shweta Rai, and I'm a program manager on the Azure AD engineering team at Microsoft.
And I'm James Poindexter, also a program manager on the Azure AD engineering team.
We are part of the customer experience team, and we help enterprises and businesses from all over the world to deploy our services and get to the cloud. We get a lot of questions about how Azure AD works under the hood, which we will share with you throughout this architecture series. In the last video, we discussed the registration process for passwordless phone sign-in on a device using the Microsoft Authenticator. In today's session, we'll take a deeper look at the process that occurs when a user signs in using the Microsoft Authenticator. At this point, we're assuming that the user has registered for passwordless phone sign-in. If you'd like to know more about this process, please see our previous video on registering for passwordless authentication with Microsoft Authenticator or visit aka.ms/passwordless. James, want to get us started?
So let's say our user wants to sign into their work account to access a company resource, and they have not authenticated just yet. After typing the username on the web page and selecting Next, users are presented with a number and are prompted to match that number on their mobile device. If successful, they will be granted access instead of having to use their password. Now, let's take a look at what is happening behind the scenes. In our previous example, our user wants to access some company resource. When they type in their user principal name and submit it to Azure AD, Authentication Services determines that the user is attempting to sign in using Microsoft Authenticator. Authentication Services will then generate a few things. To start, it will create a session for this authentication. Additionally, it will generate a set of three pseudo-randomly generated two-digit numbers. One number will be sent to the browser to be displayed on the web page, while all three numbers will be sent to the Authenticator app via push notification through the Apple or Google Cloud messaging system. The user is then presented with three numbers that they must match with the number shown on the browser. The user could also choose to deny the request, which terminates the session and thus the authentication. When the user selects the code displayed in the authenticator, they will then be prompted for the device PIN or biometric gesture. The device PIN or biometric gesture is used to access the private key on the device.
So James, why do we require the user to match the number when the private key is only accessible with the device PIN or biometrics?
Great question. From a technical perspective, the private keys can only be unlocked and accessed through the device PIN or biometrics. This additional step is simply proof of presence that you are in front of the browser so that you do not accidentally approve the wrong notification. A nonce is then signed using the private key and returned to Authentication Services, which then verifies the signed nonce and checks if the user correctly matched the number on the authenticator. Finally, once Authentication Services validates the signed nonce and the number selected by the user, it generates a token and presents it to the browser. At this point, the user is authenticated to access the resource, and this completes the flow.
We hope you found this video useful. We will be adding more videos on passwordless offerings, such as Windows Hello for Business, FIDO2 security keys, as well as other topics like provisioning, governance, and many more. If you want to get a copy of the diagrams we used today, or want to give us feedback and help us figure out what to cover, please follow the link in the description below.
Thanks for watching.
Thank you.